Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I am Aisha Ibrahim. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Safriya Palace a delegation from the U.S. Senate led by two U.S. Congress members, Jackie Rosen and Senate James Lanford, on the occasion of their visit to Bahrain. His Majesty the King welcomed the guests and reviewed with them the deep-rooted historic relations between the two countries. His Majesty affirmed his pride in the strategic relations and strong partnership between Bahrain and the U.S. and the long-standing trust, mutual respect, cooperation and coordination on all fields, expressing Bahrain's aspirations to continue to bolster these relations and develop them at all levels as friends and allies. His Majesty the King affirmed the importance of such visits that contribute to strengthening friendship relations and cooperation and to exchange points of view on various challenges in the region. His Majesty noted the U.S.'s vital role in establishing peace, security and stability and maintaining world peace, hailing the effective efforts of the countries of the region and the U.S. in all fields to protect international navigation, oil supply and world trade. He affirmed Bahrain's keenness on supporting these efforts and enhancing them. For its part, the U.S. Senate delegation expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for his efforts and keenness on developing and establishing historic relations between the two countries. They expressed pride in the deep partnership, commending Bahrain's vital role and its supporting stances towards the endeavors to establish peace, security and stability. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa deputized His Majesty the King's personal representative, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad Al Khalifa, to attend the reception held in honor of the heads of the kingdom's diplomatic missions abroad and senior foreign affairs ministries officials, marking the Bahrain Diplomacy Day celebrated every year on January 14th. His Majesty the King's representative for humanitarian work and youth affairs, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, Royal Court Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, and advisor to His Majesty the King for diplomatic affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Muhammad Al Khalifa, attended the ceremony held at Qadibiya Palace.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سمو الشيخ عبد الله بن حمد آل خليفة الممثل الشخصي لجلالة الملك المعظم، أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها الحضور الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. يسعدنا أن نرحب بكم أجمل ترحيب في هذا الاحتفال الذي يقام بمناسبة يوم الدبلوماسية البحرينية، وخير ما نبدأ به تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ علي صلاح عمر.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول، فإن تولوا فإنما عليه ما حمل وعليكم ما حملتم، وإن تطيعوه تهتدوا، وما على الرسول إلا البلاغ المبين. وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات ليستخلفنهم في الأرض كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم، وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم، وليبدلنهم من بعد خوفهم أمنا، يعبدونني لا يشركون بي شيئا، ومن كفر بعد ذلك فأولئك هم الفاسقون. وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وأطيعوا الرسول، لعلكم ترحمون. صدق الله العظيم.
Following recitations of verses from the Holy Quran, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad delivered a speech on behalf of His Majesty the King.
يلقيها سمو الشيخ عبد الله بن حمد آل خليفة الممثل الشخصي لجلالة الملك المعظم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أصحاب السمو والمعالي، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة السفراء، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يسعدنا أن نلتقي بكم جميعا اليوم بمناسبة حلول اليوم الدبلوماسي لمملكة البحرين. هذا اليوم الذي خصصناه تقديرا للدور البارز الذي تقوم به كوادرنا الدبلوماسية في تعزيز علاقات الصداقة ومد جسور التعاون بين مملكة البحرين وكافة الدول في مختلف أرجاء العالم، استنادا إلى المبادئ الأصيلة والقيم الراسخة لوطننا وشعبنا، والتي تقوم على التسامح والتعايش والحوار المتبادل وتكريس السلام والوئام والتعاون بين شعوب العالم، مرحبين بأصحاب السعادة سفراء الدول المعتمدين لدى المملكة، ومعربين عن تقديرنا لجهودهم في تعزيز وتنمية علاقات الصداقة والتعاون بين مملكة البحرين وبلدانهم الشقيقة والصديقة. الأخوة والأخوات، لقد انتهجت الدبلوماسية البحرينية عبر مسيرتها الوطنية التي انطلقت قبل أكثر من 5 عقود نموذجاً خاصاً متفرداً عبر الانفتاح على العالم ومد يد الصداقة مع الجميع والسعي الدؤوب إلى بناء العلاقات وتبادل المصالح والتواصل الحضاري مع العالم بمختلف أقطاره وثقافاته وحضاراته، فتمكنت بفضل من الله عز وجل أن تسجل العديد من مراتب التفوق والنجاح التي عكست سياسة مملكة البحرين الخارجية المعتدلة والمتزنة، وعبرت عن أصالة بلدنا وشعبها الطيب الذي يتمنى الخير والأمن والسلام والاستقرار والنماء للبشرية جمعاء. ويسرنا في هذا اليوم أن نعرب عن خالص الاعتزاز بما يبذله من يمثل الدبلوماسية البحرينية من جهود مثمرة وعطاء متواصل داخل الوطن وخارجه، وما يتحلون به من قيم راسخة وثقافة عالية وإخلاص بالبذل والعطاء خدمة لوطنها وتحقيق مصالح العليا والدفاع عن مواقفه وإبراز إنجازات مسيرته التنموية الشاملة، مؤكدين أن مملكة البحرين سوف تواصل من خلال سياستها الخارجية الطموحة القيام بدورها الفاعل في المجتمع الدولي لدعم أهداف التنمية المستدامة وتعزيز وحماية حقوق الإنسان وحرياته وإرساء السلام والاستقرار العالمي والدعوة إلى تسوية النزاعات بالطرق الدبلوماسية واحترام القوانين والأعراف والمواثيق الدولية. وفي الختام نسأل المولى العلي الغدير أن يوفق الجميع لأداء مهامهم وواجباتهم الوطنية بكل كفاءة واقتدار كما تعودنا منهم، تحقيقاً لما تصبو إليه بلادنا من تقدم ورقي وازدهار ومكانة رفيعة بين الأمم وتعزيز دورها العالمي في نشر قيم السلام والوئام والحوار المشترك وكل ما في خير وصالح شعوب العالم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
يلقي الآن سعادة الدكتور عبد اللطيف.
Then Foreign Affairs Minister Dr. عبد اللطيف بن راشد الزياني delivered the following speech.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على الرسول الكريم نبينا محمد الصادق الأمين، سمو الشيخ عبد الله بن حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة الممثل الشخصي لجلالة الملك المعظم حفظكم الله، أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة الحضور الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يشرفني يا صاحب السمو في هذا اليوم المبارك الميمون بالأصالة عن نفسي ونيابة عن جميع منتسبي وزارة الخارجية أن أرفع إلى المقام السامي لسيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المعظم حفظه الله ورعاه أسمى آيات الشكر والامتنان والعرفان لما يوليه جلالته من دعم ورعاية لوزارة الخارجية ودبلوماسيها، وما يبديه جلالته دائماً من توجيهات سامية سديدة تجاه تعزيز السياسة الخارجية لمملكة البحرين والارتقاء بالعمل الدبلوماسي لتحقيق الأهداف الوطنية النبيلة التي يسعى جلالته إلى تحقيقها في مد جسور التعاون مع جميع دول العالم وحماية مصالح الوطن ومواطنيه في الداخل والخارج، ونشر قيم السلام والتسامح والتعايش بين شعوب العالم، وحماية حقوق الإنسان وحرياته وكرامته، وتعزيز مكانة المملكة بين دول العالم. ويسرني أن أتقدم إلى سموكم الكريم بوافر الشكر والتقدير على استقبالكم اليوم نيابة عن جلالة الملك المعظم، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، رؤساء البعثات الدبلوماسية في الخارج، في يوم الدبلوماسية البحرينية الذي خصصه جلالته أيده الله للاحتفاء بالأسرة الدبلوماسية وعطائها السخي، تقديراً من جلالته للدبلوماسية ودورها الفاعل في تنفيذ السياسة الخارجية للمملكة، ودعماً منه لأبنائه الدبلوماسيين والدبلوماسيات وما يقومون به من جهود وطنية مخلصة في سبيل رفعة الوطن الغالي وتقدمه وازدهاره، وأنه لفخر كبير للدبلوماسية البحرينية أن تلقى هذا الدعم المتواصل والرعاية السامية من لدن جلالة الملك المعظم حفظه الله ورعاه، ومن صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله، بما نلمسه من سموه من حرص واهتمام بتعزيز العلاقات الدبلوماسية وتنمية التعاون الثنائي بين مملكة البحرين ومختلف دول العالم. ونحن في وزارة الخارجية فخورون أيضاً بأننا سوف نحتفل غداً برعاية كريمة مقدرة من صاحب السمو الملكي ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء، وبحضور سمو الشيخ محمد بن مبارك آل خليفة الممثل الخاص لجلالة الملك المعظم، بتخريج كوكبة من الدبلوماسيين البحرينيين ممن اجتازوا بنجاح الدورة الدبلوماسية التأسيسية من أكاديمية محمد بن مبارك آل خليفة للدراسات الدبلوماسية، معربين عن بالغ الاعتزاز بالدور البارز والجهود المخلصة التي بذلها سموه في قيادة سفينة الدبلوماسية البحرينية بجهد وطني مخلص وكفاءة عالية واقتدار رفيع في ظل ظروف إقليمية ودولية صعبة وتحديات جسيمة، من أجل تأكيد سيادة واستقلال مملكة البحرين ومكانتها الدولية الرفيعة بين دول العالم. فلسموه منا كل الشكر والثناء والتقدير. والشكر واجب لمعالي الأخ الشيخ خالد بن أحمد بن محمد آل خليفة مستشار جلالة الملك للشؤون الدبلوماسية على الجهود الموفقة التي بذلها معاليه بكل إخلاص وجدارة وأداء مميز خلال توليه منصب وزير الخارجية، ودوره البارز في توثيق علاقات الصداقة والتعاون الثنائي بين مملكة البحرين والعديد من دول العالم. إننا في وزارة الخارجية ماضون بعون الله ورعايته في تنفيذ التوجيهات السامية والرؤية الثاقبة لجلالة الملك المعظم حفظه الله ورعاه، مستهدين بنهجه السامي نهج الاعتدال والاتزان والمرونة لبناء علاقات وثيقة ومتميزة مع دول العالم تقوم على الاحترام المتبادل والتفاهم المشترك والحوار البناء وتكريس قيم التسامح والتعايش والتفاعل مع مختلف الحضارات والثقافات، حريصين على تعزيز وحماية حقوق الإنسان وحرياته وكرامته وترسيخ دعائم الأخوة والتضامن والتكاتف مع دول مجلس التعاون والدول العربية والإسلامية الشقيقة، وتوطيد التعاون الفاعل والمثمر مع المجتمع الدولي في إطار القوانين والمواثيق الدولية ومقاصد وأهداف الأمم المتحدة في الحفاظ على الأمن والسلم الدوليين وتحقيق التنمية المستدامة وتعزيز التعاون والتنسيق المشترك لمواجهة كافة التحديات. وستظل هذه السياسة الخارجية لمملكة البحرين ثابتة وراسخة فاعلة ومؤثرة تعبر عن رؤية جلالة الملك المعظم وحكمته المعهودة، وتعكس قيم مجتمعنا الأصيلة وتطلعاتنا الوطنية وإرثنا الحضاري والثقافي العريق. نسأل الله العلي القدير أن يحفظ جلالة الملك المعظم ويمد في عمر جلالته لتحقيق تطلعاته السامية لنهضة هذا الوطن الغالي وتقدمه ورقيه بين دول العالم. والشكر واجب لسموكم على هذا الاستقبال، متمنين لسموكم دوام التوفيق والسداد، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
هدية تذكارية إلى سيدي جلالة الملك المعظم حفظه الله ورعاه.
The minister then handed a commemorative gift presented by the Foreign Affairs Ministry to His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad. Under the patronage of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and on behalf of His Royal Highness, the Special Representative of His Majesty the King, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, attended the graduation ceremony of 7 batches of diplomats from the Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa Academy for Diplomatic Studies, MBMA, organized by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in the presence of senior officials and heads of Bahrain's diplomatic missions abroad, as well as ambassadors. The ceremony began with the national anthem, and a documentary film was displayed highlighting the history of Bahraini diplomacy and the career of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak as the First Minister of Foreign Affairs and the establishment of MBMA and its efforts to qualify diplomats in the ministry. The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Abdel Latif Al-Sayani, delivered a speech in which he congratulated His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister for the unlimited support to the ministry and its affiliates and the royal directives that resulted in Bahrain being a regional and international model of tolerance, peace, respect for human rights and support for sustainable development. He also thanked His Royal Highness for patronizing the ceremony. He thanked His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak for attending the ceremony on behalf of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. He expressed appreciation to the advisor of His Majesty the King for Diplomatic Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, for his efforts and significant accomplishments during his tenure. He affirmed that the ceremony is a culmination of the national efforts of MBMA, led by its Director General Sheikh Dr. Munira bint Khalifa bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and its contributions to preparing diplomatic and administrative cadres. He thanked the ambassadors for their efforts to develop relations between Bahrain and their countries. The MBMA Director General briefed the audience on the Academy's establishment and achievements, and 2 graduates delivered speeches. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak honored the outstanding graduates of each diplomatic batch and distributed certificates to the graduates. The Minister of Foreign Affairs presented His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak with a commemorative gift on the occasion. His Highness expressed pride in His Majesty the King's establishment of the Academy and thanked His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister for delegating him to patronize the ceremony. The Special Representative praised the efforts of the Foreign Affairs Minister and the Academy's Director General in preparing future Bahraini diplomats. He congratulated the graduates and wished them success in carrying out their diplomatic duties and performing their national role in advancing the kingdom's diplomatic work internationally and developing its relations with other countries.
It's been such a pleasure today to celebrate the achievements of the Academy, our wonderful leadership, and all the work that we've done to get us to the place where we are today. I think I would love to thank our leaders, Her Excellency Dr. Munira, for all the work she's done, for bringing us to this moment and helping us achieve this wonderful, wonderful event. I'm very proud to be here today to be celebrating our leadership and all their hard work and their gratitude.
His Majesty the King's Special Representative, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, received the heads of diplomatic missions in the presence of advisor to His Majesty the King for Diplomatic Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, and Foreign Affairs Minister Dr. Abdul Latif bin Rashid Al Zayani on the occasion of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs celebration of Bahrain's Diplomacy Day. His Highness Sheikh Mohammed congratulated the ambassadors on this occasion and praised their sincere effort to implement Bahrain's foreign policy, take care of its interests abroad, and strengthen external bilateral relations, as well as enhance its international status. His Highness affirmed that the foreign policy of Bahrain throughout its history has been based on the constructive interaction and communication and establishing friendship and cooperation with all countries in implementation of the directives of Bahrain's leadership and the high performance of its diplomacy based on moderation, wishing the heads of diplomatic missions a continued success. Dr. Zayani expressed appreciation to His Highness Sheikh Mohammed's support to the ministry and all diplomats, wishing His Highness lasting good health and happiness. National Audit Office NAO's Auditor General Sheikh Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa presented the 19th NAO Annual Report 2021-2022 to Representatives Council Speaker Ahmed bin Salman Lemsalem and Shura Council Chairman Ali bin Saleh Al-Saleh. Lemsalem affirmed that strengthening the oversight role and preserving public money are among the priorities of the Council and supporting the development of national action in light of the Comprehensive Development March of His Majesty the King and with the support and follow-up of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. He stated that the NAO is an important part and a fundamental pillar of the oversight system, which supports the work of the Council by monitoring the safety and legality of the use of public money and its management. He also indicated that parliamentary interaction with the report will witness a new methodology in researching and studying that is stated in the report to achieve the desired goals. The speaker praised the efforts and role of the Auditor General and all the office's employees in preserving public money. For his part, the Auditor General affirmed that the NAO's achievements, tasks and responsibilities are thanks to the wise directives of His Majesty the King and the support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister and his directives to the entities covered by the NAO's audit mandate to follow up on the implementation of the recommendations and observations contained in the NAO's report. He expressed appreciation for the Council's cooperation. The Shura Council held its weekly meeting presided over by its chairman, Ali Al-Saleh. The Council approved Decree Bylaw 31 of 2022, amending a number of provisions of Decree Bylaw 6 of 1991 regarding the establishment of a pension fund for Bahraini and non-Bahraini officers and personnel of the BDF and public security. The Council also approved a Decree Bylaw 33 of 2022, amending a number of provisions of Decree Bylaw 15 of 1986 on regulating tourism. The Minister of Municipalities Affairs and Agriculture, Engineer Wael bin Nasser Limbarak, met with the UAE Minister of Climate Change and Environment, Dr. Maryam bint Mohammed Al-Muhairi, where they discussed frameworks for joint cooperation and ways to enhance them in the fields of municipalities, agriculture, food security and marine wealth. Al-Mubarak affirmed a keenness to continue strengthening the historical fraternal relations between Bahrain and UAE in light of the interest and support of His Majesty the King and the President of the UAE. He discussed the development of municipal facilities and services and exchanging bilateral experiences between the two countries. The two ministers also discussed activating the Memorandum of Understanding in the field of food security and municipal work, in addition to benefiting from the International Center for Biosaline Agriculture. The minister noted that Bahrain has implemented several initiatives in the field of municipalities and food security. Al-Mubarak also reviewed Bahrain's experience in implementing the afforestation plan, stressing that Bahrain was able to achieve the strategic goals it had set in the field of afforestation during last year. For her part, the UAE minister praised Bahrain's efforts in adopting initiatives that ensure the sustainability of food security and the promotion of the environmental sector. She stressed keenness to consolidate the partnership with the kingdom in issues of climate change and enhancing cooperation and coordination in this field. The Minister of Electricity and Water Affairs Yasser bin Ibrahim Hamidan participated in the 13th session of the International Renewable Energy Agency Assembly held in Abu Dhabi. The minister affirmed Bahrain's commitment to its declared goals of reaching net zero neutrality by 2060 and implementing interim goals related to renewable energy and energy efficiency. The minister noted Bahrain's keenness to double its efforts in this framework and within its comprehensive development path and its 2030 economic vision to achieve sustainable development goals, especially those related to sustainable energy, in addition to international efforts to address climate change. He stressed that strengthening international relations and establishing important partnerships with the private sector at the national and regional levels are among the important strategies that the ministry focuses on. The Ministry of Housing and Urban Planning, in cooperation with the Housing Bank and under the patronage of the Minister of Housing and Urban Planning, Amna bint Ahmed Al-Ramehi, organized a joint meeting with a number of real estate development companies, banks and commercial banks to introduce the mechanisms for participating in the bids for offering the first package of the Governmental Land Development Rights Program. The package includes the implementation of 771 residential units and apartments in Salman and Khalifa towns. The ministry and the Housing Bank reviewed the implementation plan for the government land rights development program in partnership with the private sector to provide 19,000 housing units. The program is within the framework of implementing the royal directives to continue the implementation and development plans for the housing sector with its innovative solutions and investments to secure adequate housing for citizens. Details related to the bids for the implementation of 131 units and 360 apartments in Salman City and 280 units in Khalifa City and investment opportunities for the implementation of these projects were reviewed. It was also emphasized that the necessary support will be provided and companies and banks would provide information regarding the mechanism used within the program for bids in the government land investment platform. Bahrain International Airport BIA received a 5-star rating from Skytrax, the world's top airport and airline rating body, for the second year in a row in recognition of the high standards of its facilities and services. Skytrax announced the ranking, which followed an assessment concluded in November 2022 that included several criteria, including direct services for departures, arrivals, diverted flights, airport facilities and customer services, security, immigration and retails, as well as food and beverage facilities. The 5-star airport rating is the highest mark of quality distinction awarded by Skytrax for an airport. The National Bureau for Revenue, NBR, launched the NBR Digital Stamp mobile application for smartphones in conjunction with the completion of the digital stamp scheme on some products, which will enable users to scan the digital stamp QR code on the products to ensure that the product is authentic and the information displayed meets the standards. The digital stamp scheme aims to track excise goods from the manufacturing stage up to consumption through security features and codes on the digital stamp. In the case where the product information doesn't match or no digital stamp is placed on the product, users are urged to cooperate with NBR by submitting a report through the app that will be referred to the relevant authorities for investigation. The mobile app is currently available for download, with more details provided on NBR's website. The Rashid Equestrian and Horse Racing Club organized the 13th race of the season, which was postponed from its scheduled date last Friday due to weather conditions. The race was held for the Bahrain Jewelry Center Cup, Porsche Cup and Fatais Al Hadri Cup in the presence of their highnesses and representatives of the race sponsors and horse racing fans. Trophies were presented to the winners after the race. Sebastian Loeb gave Bahrain Raid Extreme the lead in the 2023 World Rally Raid Championship today, as Nasser Al Atiyah secured his fifth Dakar Rally victory in Saudi Arabia. Ghislaine Chichrit and Alex Winnock took the final 136-kilometer stage from Al Hufuf to Dammam for their second success in this year's event, and a ninth Pro Drive Hunter win of the 14th stage and the toughest Dakar since the rally moved to Saudi 3 years ago. After powering his BRX Pro Drive Hunter into the record books with a sixth stage victory in a row 24 hours earlier, Loeb coasted to the finish in Dammam to secure his second successive overall Dakar runner-up spot with co-driver Fabian Lurquin. That will come in next month's Abu Dhabi Desert Challenge, where Loeb will take to build on his WTRC lead with further rounds to follow in Mexico, Argentina, and Morocco.